ass. Mm-hmm. Come on. Y'all boys don't know nothing about me.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Boxing YouTube reverse what it is, what's happening. You know who it is. It's Nocturnal Thoughts coming at you with a real quick video, man. Everybody talking about it was watching H Money, watching Blood Boxing, and everybody right now is roasting and toasting and flaming, you know what I'm saying, hot fire flame on Errol Spence for that little 15 second clip, you know what I'm saying, 15 second clip of him and Yellow Beezy hugged up, snuggling up, and brotherly love, however you want to fashion it, man. It was not a good look, you know what I'm saying? It was not a good look. Now, come to my channel, I'm gonna be honest with you, I always try to keep it 100. I try to keep it, you know what I'm saying, a buck. I try to keep it 4 quarters, 10 dimes, 20 nickels, and 100 pennies. But at the same time, I'm not perfect. I don't throw stones. I don't try to, you know what I'm saying, kick nobody when they down. It's just not my MO. But I try to keep it real. Even if I support you, if I see you doing something that I feel like, you know what I'm saying, you need to be check yourself before you wreck yourself type of thing, then I just gotta call it how I see it. And it ain't no other way to see it. It just is not a good look. You know what I'm saying? It's just not a good look for Errol Spence. Period, point blank. It ain't a good look. You know what I'm saying? You can't go from zero personality to that type of a personality and then put it for everybody to see. It's just not what's happening. Period, point blank. And to do damage control, to redeem yourself, to try to, you know what I'm saying, help out your brand and you know, and reface, give your brand a facelift, or a new face, or a makeover, or whatever you want to call it. You need to fight. There's only one way to redeem it. You know, even though nowadays 15 seconds of fame and 15 seconds of shame don't last the same. It's 5 seconds nowadays, and then people go on to the next. But at the same time, man, you a fighter. The only thing you need to be known for is fighting. You know what I'm saying? Period, point blank. That's it. Fight Terrence Bud Crawford and win, or fight Ennis, Jerron Boots Ennis, and win, and then that'll be that. Other than that, I don't see you being able to make that look right. It's just way too comfortable. You look way too comfortable. I'm gonna put it like this, man. You can't drink. You can't hold your liquor, and you don't need to drink. It's not for everybody. I don't drink. It's not my thing. You know what I'm saying? I had 5 uncles. I only got 2 left. But is it 2, 3, 4 passed away? I don't even know, man. I'd have had so many uncles pass away. But kryptonite, man. Alcohol is kryptonite to my blood, to my family. And kryptonite to my father is kryptonite to my uncles. Alcohol is not good, period. It's gonna cause you to have a lapse in judgment, you know what I'm saying? And at the same time, they always say, you know, a drunk man never lies. Now, I'm not gonna take it as far as some people gonna take it and try to label you and label your sexuality based off of something like that, because I've been on this earth too long. I done seen too many things to know that, you know, I'm just not gonna judge nobody, you know what I'm saying? To each is his own. But I don't condemn, and I definitely don't condone. I just don't condone that. That's not in my MO. I feel like, you know, to each is his own. Some people be on that. A lot of people I was listening to all last night, all back of my day this, and man, and I be back in the, and it's like, you know, all that I just kind of let go in one ear and out the other, because I know better. It's like, please, man, you ain't fooling nobody. Some of these dudes be just acting. That's why if the generation before, because I'm 41, if the generation before was so just man this and man that, and it was all a man and everything was, then the generation of today wouldn't be as jacked up as it is now. You know what I'm saying? saying? Generation after generation after generation after generation of men become less and less and less, and drop the ball and drop the ball and drop the ball, and it's less real men trying to pick up the balls and put it back together. That's period, point blank. You know what I'm saying? Please. And you know, like they talked about the video with the skinny jeans and him and Yellow Beezy and the other dude with the little braids dancing around. I can't watch stuff like that for too much. I'm like, I can't even watch that for too much. But when I do see it, I just see, like, I see what I always seen, you know, my whole life. Like, baggy jeans only was in style for a little while, man. It always been mugs and skinny jeans. And then it got to baggy jeans. Then it got to baggy and saggy. Then it turned to skinny jeans and sagging. And it's like, to me, once you get down to it, when you get grown and you're not following the trend and you're not trying to be cool and you're just a man, you just learn how to buy clothes that fit you. You feel, you realize you have a waistline, a belt. You put a belt on, your pants fit you. You know how long your legs is and where they're supposed to fall at on your boots, period, point blank. So you don't get caught up in the trends and trying to, you know what I'm saying, be fashionable when you return. Men, a man don't go out of style. A woman don't go out of style. Trends, they come and go. But when I see the trends in the fashion, that's going to always be. You can go way back to it. I remember Grandmaster Flash or Houdini or, you know what I'm saying? Don't kick me, don't push me, because I'm close to the edge. And Rick James and all these, the Prince. I mean, when it comes to fashion, fashion always been like unisexual or whatever. Fashion and people dressing nice and colors and all that stuff, that's always been where they try to blur the lines between sexuality, in my opinion. So I don't even get off into that. And then skinny jeans, yeah, I mean, if that's what you want to wear, that's what you, that, I'm not comfortable wearing skinny jeans. I'm not comfortable wearing baggy jeans. I'm comfortable wearing jeans that fit, you dig? 36-34 with a cuff, or 36-32. That's what I feel comfortable wearing, with a belt on and a shirt tucked in. And a real man, if you stay in shape and keeping yourself fit, then it's all you need is some regular t-shirt and jeans and put that on. You don't need to be all caught up in the fashion. Anyways, man, but I gotta say this, why it's on my mind, because it just one of those things. It's a nocturnal thought, you know what I'm saying? It's a nocturnal thought. When you're talking about the alcohol, when you're talking about the kissing, when you're talking about the dancing, I'm losing my train of thought, man. What I was gonna say, damn, it's gonna have to come to me later, man. It's been a long one, it's been a long night, but I was talking about, you know what I'm saying, the trend, oh yeah, I was in Texas on my vacation. This is what I was gonna say, because this blows me my, look, I don't go out. I go to work, I go to the gym, and I go home. So when I'm talking about, when I see the skinny jeans and the sagging and all that, I know that's just all around the world. But I don't go out, I don't see it when I'm home. When I was in Texas on my vacation, you know, you got to go out. You got to go to the malls. You got to go all around and go to eat all the restaurants. We went to all the restaurants, man. Turkey Leg, Turkey Hut, or whatever. The Breakfast Club. We went to a bunch of joints anyways. But when we was at the mall, we went to the mall to walk around. You know what I mean? Do some window shopping. And I seen something I had never seen before like this. In Texas, and I wasn't gonna talk about it because I wasn't trying to act like I'm throwing Texas under the bus, you know what I'm saying? Because I thought Texas, I liked some things about Texas, but this is my first time seeing it because I don't go out when I'm home. I'm walking, I'm getting bored, and I'm looking down, and I see this dude walk past me, and he got on some clean Jordans, man. The low tops, red bubblegum bottom, white with the black patent leather. And I'm like, man, those is clean. I'm following up and I see he had on some like jeans that kind of matched. It was the skinny leg jeans and he had the sag, and I'm like, okay, cool, but I'm seeing the fit. And then he got his ass hanging all the way out and he got on some underwear that got Unity. Unity. He got unity across his butt, and it's in different colors. I don't know if y'all see this all the time. This is my first time seeing it. And he walking with a female. And she probably wasn't bad looking. I didn't see her face because I'm just seeing, you know what I'm saying, he had walked past me. But he with a female. And I'm like, that's what the style is these days, I guess. I ain't even say nothing because I was tired. You know, I'm just like, I just was a people watcher. And I said it reminded me of when the women back in the day used to wear the sweatpants that had Juicy going across the back. You know, so when it comes to like what kids doing in this generation, man, it just is what it is, man. I definitely don't get it. I ain't with it. I'm not down with it. My son, he's 17. Him, he don't dress like that. His friends don't dress like that. My, all his friends is like tall, long, 6'3" mugs, and they pants all fit them right. I don't know. Maybe when they get out, when they get away from us, from the adults, they hurry up and bust a sag. I don't know, but it is what it is. All I'm saying is, Errol Spence, man, stay away from that bottle. That drinking is not for you. You need to stick with the Pepsi Colas. You need to stick with the Coca Colas and the Pepsi Cola. You need to be focused and get your mind right. I'm gonna be honest with you. I always figured in a fight with you and Terrence Bud Crawford, you at 100% would be too tough. But you know, if you're gonna be getting laxed and comfortable and drinking and not giving your body everything that it need, you're gonna see, man. You're gonna come up short if you ever fight Terrence Bud Crawford. But if you fight a real legit diehard guy that's just dedicated and got your number, and you've been taking shortcuts and you've been you know, enjoying the recreational time too much and not on your game, you're gonna come up short. You're gonna, it's not gonna happen. You're not gonna be able to stand tall when you tearing down your foundation. I'm just gonna be honest with you, man. I wish nothing but the best for you. And I know probably it's just pressure. It's just pressure because your personality is really low key and you're trying to come up out your shell. Some people need that alcohol courage. But you don't need that, man. Stay low key, man. Stay quiet, man. That's what I thought was respectful about you, is that you just kept to yourself and you didn't show your hand. You didn't show all this personality. You just fought in the ring like you were supposed to do. But now it's like, you know, you ain't got to be chasing this fame outside of the ring. You just don't. It don't fit you, and it's not going to fit you, and it ain't going to get you like blood. Say, y'all ain't making that money like Errol Smith, like Mayweather. Y'all not. I don't care what you do. You're not going to make that type of money. It ain't about the money. A man, being a man trumps money. Being a man trumps fashion. Being a man is the most high. It's God first, then being a man. Everything else falls short of that. Don't try to make all the money in the world. Don't try to have all the most beautiful girls in the world and have all the most material things. All that stuff gonna go. It's gonna fade. Just be a man. You know what I'm saying? And that's what it is. That's all I gotta say, man. Nocturnal Thoughts. Salute.
Kick ass! Kick ass! Come on.